The Southern California fires are burning for a pretty simple reason that has nothing to do with AI, water agreements, or LA's spending habits. Extremely strong winds came before seasonal rains. First, let's talk about why this happened. So fall 2022 through spring of 2024 were super wet years for the LA region with deadly rain and costly flooding. It also created a flush of new vegetation. The rain stopped just in time for record-setting summer heat with no meaningful precipitation for 8 months. Typically, December through February is the rainiest season in LA, but so far this year, not so much. 2024 ended as the hottest year on record, and a warmer atmosphere holds more moisture, pulling water out of vegetation quicker. So all of that new growth transformed into receptive fuel for fires by hot, thirsty air. And if you add a spark to the California Santa Ana winds, you have an extremely fast fire, which we're told over and over cannot be put out until the wind dies down. Thousands of people are losing their homes and some even their lives. And these fires will almost certainly make up the most expensive fire event in California in US history. The Palisades fire also ripped through one of the most precarious insurance markets in the state. And that could even have ripple effects or even tidal wave impacts far outside of the fire perimeter. This state insurer called California Fair Plan had just $200 million available to pay in claims in March of 2024. So residents are likely to run into an expensive situation. Private insurance companies in the market are required to foot up to $1 billion of the Fair Plan's payouts. Anything over that is paid for by all of California's taxpayers. And as of January 10th, 2025, this event is thought to be causing over $130 billion of damage, according to early estimates by AccuWeather. But insurance consultant Nancy Watkins also told us that she sees this fire as an opportunity to focus on a long-term solution where insurers pay the risk more accurately and focus on reducing loss from future fires by designing and retrofitting homes and communities for wildfire according to the best science available. But this will mean significantly increased insurance costs in the short term.